Hi, how's it going?
I wanted to talk to some of the parents out there. How is it going homeschooling and taking care of your kids right now? I have so many questions because I have a 7-year-old, a 16-year-old, and a 20-year-old. It has been very interesting. I've been trying to manage their feelings, manage my own feelings, and the person that I always talk to when I have questions is Robin Berman. This is a little conversation that I had with Robin, some questions that I had for her, and I hope you guys enjoy it.
Yeah.
Look, we're both wearing pink.
We're channeling our pink today, the color of love.
Hi, Robin.
Hi.
I'm excited to talk to you.
I'm excited to share what I've been thinking about.
You tell everybody a little bit about yourself.
I am a mother, and I am a physician and associate professor of psychiatry at UCLA, and the author of a book called Permission to Parent.
You are somebody that I turn to a lot when I'm looking for advice as a parent. My first question maybe is, how do you talk to your kids about what's going on in the world?
Step one is calm your own anxiety down so we don't project it on them. Step two in telling them is channeling your inner Mr. Rogers. Because rather than saying kids can't handle it, I'm going to hide them from the truth, you have enough trust in your kids to know that they can manage it. There's also a lot of opportunities in how you teach them because you're growing resiliency. And this is their first real experience with the world coming together and there is a crisis here. So you have to say the truth in a very calm way and also give them power to help.
How do you give them power to help?
What do we have to remember when we walk in the house? We're going to wash our hands. Grandma's feeling alone right now. Let's sit down and write Grandma a card. Take care of those you love.
I've been thinking a lot about my childhood and how I spent a lot of time with my grandparents who grew up in the Depression. My grandfather, he grew a garden. He would collect the vegetables and place them every Saturday morning at his neighbor's house. My grandma would take 2 hours to bake a batch of cookies and really work on the details of the cookies. And then we would sit down and have a pretend tea party. And everything was just slower. And my parents were racing around being professionals, doctors and nurses. And my grandparents were just appreciating everything small. This is the time that we can find our best self, our part of ourself that we've always wanted to cultivate, because our creativity is inside of us and it's infinite. We're not all teachers. We're not all party clowns. We're not all comedians.
You know, my mom, I'd say, we're bored. And she'd say, spit in your shoe and call the doctor at 2:30. I'm like, what? What do you mean? It means don't ask me. Figure it out. And we did. Mm. We created forts. We planted gardens. I was so touched when you were talking about your grandparents, because I feel like all of your cells marinated in that. And I think in this crazy pace that we've been in, rates of anxiety and depression in children have never been higher in the history of the world.
Is that right?
Greater than the Great Depression, greater than World War II. Literally, the curve is straight up. I think it's just a global mirror. Kids' psyches need space, like little Reese, right? With the grandparents, all of that stuff we haven't had time to do with, myself included, too busy. There's space to, hey, I've always wanted to teach my kids how to meditate. We're all getting quiet, and we all have this incredible lesson that we're one.
We never have the time to think about how alike we all are, and I do think this is very unifying, don't you think?
That's another, where darkness is an opportunity for light. Everybody's scared. Everybody's uncertain. And a lot of people are reaching outside of themselves. Like, I've been thinking, what family can we adopt? Who's in need? Who's more vulnerable? In addition to all the craziness and all the disruption, being home with our kids and our families and our loved ones isn't so terrible.
If people are really having a tough time, are there resources that you recommend?
Meditation, in terms of, you know, getting on an app. Go Zen is an interesting website for kids and anxious kids. Going for a run is an antidepressant. Studies show that exercise is as strong in some studies as taking Zoloft or Prozac. Going for a walk is a meditation, right? Making a pie is a meditation. And those active rituals of gratitude, thank you for food, right? Now, thank you for my girlfriends. That increases good neurochemistry in your brain. This is all medical science now. It used to be what my dad called woo-woo medicine. This is real. So exercise, keeping that up as a daily ritual and taking your kids out into nature, it's the spiritual pause button. And for people like you, Miss Reese, who run and do and are the most capable, I can't even imagine what's going to come out of you when you push pause button.
I'm definitely working on some things I've never had time to do, which is really fun. I have two really specific questions that somebody asked me. One was about little kids, like 2 and 3 years old, and how to separate in a kind way so that my friend who's working, she doesn't know how to say mommy has to do a work call because her daughter breaks down into tears.
One of our biggest jobs is to be an emotion coach, to manage our children's feelings. So the number one thing I would do when a kid is, you know, bursting into tears is validating the feeling. I get it, honey. You want mommy to play with you right now. I so get it. I wish I could play with you. So you want to hold the feeling. And on the other hand, you want to hold the line. And mommy has a call, and when I'm done, I'm gonna come out and play with you. So we call this a dialectic, holding two feelings at once.
I also think we like rules. When the kids follow the rules, they need to really look them in the eye and say, I really appreciate that you gave me time to be on my call, and now I wanna look at that picture that you drew.
That's exactly right, because what you wanna do is reinforce the positive. Most people reinforce the whining. They stop listening, and every 10th time they say, okay, what is it, right? And then we're growing amazing life skills for our kids, right? They're learning to be patient. They're learning the world doesn't revolve around them.
I always say to my husband, I'm like, we have to have the kids take their dishes to the sink because whoever their partner will be will thank us later.
Oh, for sure.
My mother, because she taught pediatric nursing, she'd say, ignore the bad, reward the good. I do get this a lot. Mommy, 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 mom, 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 mousy, 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 mom, mom, mom. What? I can see you want to talk to me right now. I'm going to finish this first. And then I'll go back to you.
But and that's what kids need. They need somebody at the helm. That's why my book is called Permission to Parent. They need somebody with the reins who's a calm, clear leader.
If people haven't checked out your book, it is such an amazing book. And I really hope people will check out Permission to Parent. I have one more question before I let you go, because you and I both have teenagers. There's just a lot of disappointment. There's a lot of, I can't see my friends, which to me, a huge piece of being a teenager is having time and space to be social. And that just stopped. So how do you manage all of that disappointment?
In order for your kids to be happy, they have to tolerate being sad. That's actually the only formula to happiness. And we validate their disappointment. You want to go see your girlfriend. You want to go see your friends. You want to be a teenager. And for right now, that life as we know it is going to pause. It is not in our power to fix it, but it is in our power to pray on it, to love them, to hold them. I hope we can hold on to some of these lessons.
Those are all such incredible things. You're such a helper in this world, just like Mr. Rogers.
Thank you for all the sunshine, and thank you for all you do.
I love you so much, Robin. Bye.
Thank you so much, Robin, for sharing your wisdom and all those great parenting tips. I always feel better when I talk to Robin, so thank you. And I hope you guys enjoyed that. If you have more questions, let me know. We can do this again. Do you want to? Maybe we should. Let me know. Hi, y'all. Thank you so much for watching the video. If you want to see more content like this, subscribe here or here, like somewhere in this area. Anywhere over there.